Hey guys, MomoGuru back with Devlog video number 36 for Astrox Imperium, and today's date is October 27th, 2018. Alright, so for these past week or so, I've been still doing pretty much what I've been doing for the past month, which is a lot of playtesting and a lot of bug hunting and just polishing things up and trying to get things put together the way that I want them to be before I open this up to some more public testing. Alright, you may notice that there are some improved textures and stuff going on with the ships, and that is pretty much what happens when I get tired of testing things. I add some new pretties, something new to look at, and then I get back to the grind. I have been making some tweaks to the user interface here and there, especially with some of the functionality. As I've been, you know, playing things, I realized we needed some certain things. And one of the things that was driving me crazy is as I was doing missions and testing missions, I would have to go in here and open up my missions tab and then select my mission and then look at the objective here. And then so what I did is I created another little tab under here with the stats. And basically you just open up your little active missions tab. So with the active missions tab, you can kind of fly around and see exactly what you need to do, and you can scroll through your active missions here. Now that I'm doing this, I should just make this whole box clickable so that you don't have to even just click just these arrows. Left click should go one way, right click maybe go another. I don't know. Anyway, so we're going to go ahead and do these missions, and I can show you that I've been working on a lot of the graphical stuff. I've been redoing textures for buildings, started modeling out some of the actual buildings and the various structures. There's a new one right there. I don't have the emission map on there yet, so it's not all lit up with some cool stuff yet, but it will be. Alrighty, so where are we going? I'm just flying off in the nowhere. We need to go. We are escorting a pilot to Renoro in Temple Gates, and we need to pick him up at Security Patrol in Felishar. So I'm going to go ahead and zoom out here, and you'll notice that I've changed the way this works. So now if you just click one of these things here, it will, if your autopilot is, or I'm sorry, your GPS is activated, it'll disable it and let you select wherever you want to go. And then when you find the place you want to go, you just click it again and it'll automatically activate your GPS. You can use the G key to toggle your GPS like normal. You still have your button over here to toggle your GPS like normal. So all of that functionality still exists. It's just a lot less clicking and it's a lot easier to get to where you need to go. So again, as I've been playing and doing these things, you start to kind of figure out these little areas where you're like, you know what? I need to make some changes here to make it do exactly what I want it to do. Alrighty, I do have my afterburners going. I'm flying around on this really slow transport carrier. I should probably dock over here and see possibly if I can just pick up something faster, because I need to do an escort mission, and I believe my other one is a kill mission. Yeah, I gotta kill one level 10 raider, and then I gotta come back here to void Starcross. So I'm gonna go ahead and dock it with this guy, the Proctor Center. I know they've got some good ships. I have been pretty much handcrafting all of these stations and making sure that they have exactly the items I want you to have at exactly the moment I want you to have them. And as you know, now with the gate keys and everything, I've kind of showed those in another video, I can limit your progression and start to really tailor how far, how fast you can get, and with what kind of hurdles in your path. So I'm really looking forward to doing some of that. But before I do, I'm just plowing through this right now, trying to get everything functioning really, really nice and neat. I really like the way some of these station textures are looking now. Alrighty, what do we need to do? We needed to pick up somebody. Oh no! We needed to buy a new ship because that ship is way too slow. Again, making small little detailed changes to the UI and kind of layering things out. What do we want? We want something. There you go. There's a battle cruiser. That guy's pretty decent. He's not super fast, but now that gunship, that battle utility is a little bit better. You know what? Let's go with the cruiser. Oh, crap. Okay, so that leads me to another thing. You have to train the proper skills you need to be able to fly particular ships. So I do not have the ability to fly this ship because I need to train up some skills in the universities to do that. So I can train an escort, but that's, you know what? This one has three actives, and all I really need to do, I'm gonna go ahead and buy that one. Switch over to my ship dock. I'm going to go ahead and swap to this ship, right? But I'm also going to sell off my other one. I'm gonna go ahead and just get rid of it. What that's gonna do is drop all the items and everything that I had installed right here in the storage, so I'm able to take back whatever I can, and clearly I can't take everything. So let's go ahead and do this. Let's get rid of some of these extra little boogers. We definitely don't need to be carrying around any atomite. So let's get rid of that. We'll get rid of that quasar. We'll get rid of that gradion. That's just taking up space. We'll head back to the storage, and I'm gonna grab a couple of these because I'm gonna throw those on my life support system. Definitely need those. So give me my hand sandwich and all my other crap. All right, good to go, good to go. I have made some changes to this particular sector, so it doesn't. It's not detrimental even without life support. But as you start to explore out, as we head out over to the other sectors, we're definitely going to need some life support. But in your starting sector, it's not going to be an issue. All right, we want to equip. Let's see what we can put on here. We got an industrial salvager. I don't know if I have that skill all the way trained up yet. I might have to wait on that one. I'll take my launcher. I will take my afterburner, and I'll take my engine core. No, let's go ahead and install those because I don't have a lot of room on here. So let's drop on that guy and that guy and that guy. And then we don't need to be keeping this junk. We can get rid of that. And then, well, what else do we need here? Basic medium beam. I think I can take that one. And we'll take that. Improved cargo expansion. I got five of those. Holy crap. Let's get rid of that. I don't need all of those. And I don't need all those miners either. Get rid of that. And let's. Oh, what else? You know what? Oh, that's a big piece. Let's get rid of those too. All right. So let's go ahead and put that laser on, and then I think we should be good enough. Ah, crap. You know what I need? I need some missiles because I don't have any. We'll pick up some explosive missiles. Just a couple hundred. Oh, I don't even have room for that. Let's try that. There we go. We'll get rid of this energy piece. Don't need that. That'll give me a little bit more room. But I think we're pretty good there, unless they have a regular beam, a laser weapon. Advanced light laser. That is a level three. I improved is level three. Light is level three. You know what? I can take another launcher with me. All right, we'll take another launcher. And I'll go ahead and slap that on. All right, so we're good to go. All right. Now we're going to head out to, where were we headed to? Fellowshar, I believe. So we're gonna head over there. We're on our way. And you'll notice here that my ship is actually moving around that station. I got a little bit of some improvements to the pathfinding stuff, so it'll find like the clearest route around it. What I really need to do is do some adjustments to the way the meshes are created for these space stations. So I'm probably going to be playing with that. And you can see down there, there's one of those new type of structures. All right, so let's head over here to Fellowshar, and I believe we are looking for a bat. What are we doing here? Oh no, we're going to pick up we're escorting somebody right now. Okay, so let's do that. And which one is that? Might be that one. Knights Imperium. No, Temple Gates. from Astrox Security. Alright, so it's this one right here, the Astrox Security Patrol. Alright, so we'll head over there, we'll fire up these afterburners. There we go. Yeah, I'm clicking way over 200. You can see it is eating the crap out of my energy. I'm going to have to take a look at that. And why exactly my armor? Oh, because I swapped ships. I need to take a look at that. That is not updating properly. So that is definitely a bug. I'm going to write that down. And let's turn that off so we can at least keep moving here. So you can see how the engine is working. It's showing a representation. You know, I'm at 16% of the max speed I've been able to hit. And you can see some of the lighting effects on the new textures I've done for some of the resources. So little by little, it's all coming together. I just have to take my time and stay focused. All right, once we get over here, I'll be able to pick this guy up. And I'm still hurting on energy. I could sit still, but maybe I dump one of those afterburners and pick up another energy core, because I'd rather fly longer than faster, because that was pretty quick. I didn't even get across the whole map. Yeah. All right, it looks like, who is that guy? Is that just a raider, or is that somebody we need to chase after? That just looks like some random raider fooling around. He might come over here. We are in a pretty high level security, so as soon as he does any kind of shenanigans, the coppers are going to show up, and we're not going to even give him a chance. All right, so our target has joined the fleet. We've got another escort with us. All right, and we got to take this guy over to Temple Gates. And Temple Gates is right. I got to go through, I believe. Yeah, I got to go through Void Starcross. So I got to pick him up. Now, let's see who we got to fight here. All right, so this guy is in Felishar, too. So, yeah, that's the raider we got to kill. All right, two birds, one stone. Let's knock this out. All right, so we need to go ahead and get our guys locked onto him. And let's fire these up. I should have repaired my armor while I was there, but oh well. I'm going to go ahead and lock my formation speed because I'm not going with afterburners. And hey, look at this. Our little helper guy is going to help us wax this weak ass. All right, and we've completed that mission. So you'll see down here. All right, we're good to go. That objective is complete. That one is not, because we got to go drop this guy off. All right, we'll take it easy on the flight over there. Yep, that's where we're headed. And let's see, I'm only getting up to about 50. Let's go ahead and power it up and unlock, because when you're in formation, you're gonna suffer a penalty to your speed anyway. So it's best you do not try to keep them locked in formation with the afterburners, because you won't get very far very fast. All right, we're gonna save some energy. I want to keep booking here, and we're just gonna cruise on over there. We still got about 3 kilometers to go. Alrighty. While we're flying over there, I can take this opportunity to show you some of the skill stuff I was talking about with those ships. And you can see down here. Now, right here with this carrier, I cheated just so that I could bypass some of that stuff, because I was doing some tests with some of the module placements with the battle carriers. But you can see I've got some of those skills listed out right here. Now, I do plan on doing some kind of separation, because I notice as you start training a nice list of skills, it'll probably be best to categorize these, because you can see they fall into some basic categories: weapons, excavation, missions, ship, fleet. So I can break them apart and just give you a little drop down, so when you click it, it kind of opens up and shows you that. All right. Well, here we are. Let's go ahead and jump back into Void Starcross. And then from Void Starcross, we are going to head across to the Purple Station. We are pretty low on energy, so let's go ahead and dock here real quick. Unless that is a power generator, and no, it is not. Sometimes you get lucky. What I need to do is go ahead and... that is a habitation module. I bet you that would heal up my life support. I don't know which one it does yet. But basically, when you get within range of some of these structures, they have special abilities and things that they will help you out with. All right, so we're charged up there. I'm gonna jump into the garage and repair my armor. Let's get that fixed. And we'll head back out over to, we are going over there. Oops, over there to that purple one. Yeah, Temple Gates. So we're gonna book on over to Temple. Fire up my afterburner here. And then once we do that, I can drop that off. Now, where was I supposed to go for this mission? Starbase. So before I head there, let me just go ahead and dock here and turn this mission in real quick. One of the good things is you can go and, you know, train up your mission skills so that you're able to check out that cool little billboard, so that you're able to, you know, take on a good number of missions. Because once you do that, it's going to, oops, ran out of juice. Once you do that, it's really going to help you, you know, kind of plan out, you know, two or three missions on a run so that you're making some good money. And then you can get up to those bigger ships much faster. You know, the object is to try to get up to at least a cruiser, you know, fairly quickly so that you can, you're not wasting your time. You're making real money. You can start taking on real fights and, you know, playing with the big boys. But, you know, you don't have enough money to get those really specialized ships yet. So you still got to kind of wait for those. All right. Let's see. We're in here. Let's go ahead and jump into the missions so we can get our monies. All righty. Hey, we got 2 skill points for that. That's pretty awesome. All right. And then the last mission we have left is to drop this guy off. And we're on our way to do that. So let's undock. And we are headed right over to this one. So we're going to go in through that warp gate. And that should take us right to Temple Gates. I'm going to go ahead and book it over there as fast as possible. Check that dude out. That's awesome. He's rocking the mullet with the squished up aviators. All right. So we're heading on over here. I do have a lot of plans to kind of build out these little sectors. I'm still playing around with some ideas for the functionality between the structures themselves, how I want you to be able to kind of link up and how you almost have to link up some of your structures with power generators and things like that to get them to function properly. So that's definitely something I want to fool around with. Oh, I'm tempted just to go through the warp gate, but I know I should probably dock and rejuice with some energy. Yeah, let's do that. I don't have a lot of juice, yeah. I don't have any juice whatsoever. That's the only thing that sucks with these little ships. Like, they just burn up their energy so quickly. Oh, man. We're getting close. You know what? If I'm going to have to crawl over there, screw it. I'm just going to jump through the warp gate. Make it through. All right. So here we are in Temple Gate. And we need to go to Rono. There. Ranaro. All right. Head on over. I'm glad it's not too far. All right. That's not bad at all. And look at that. I even got a little bit of energy recharging. Not for long. I'll start stuttering here before you know it. So you can see when you start running out of juice, now I'm dropping from 48 down to, like, I don't know, in the very low 30s. All right, we're almost there. Just a side note, I am not being charged. If you've noticed, that $600 payroll that's been coming out is only for the two guys, the mercenaries that I've hired, just because I'm flying around with this extra mercenary doing an escort mission. You know, yeah, I can use him and do stuff, but I have to be careful because he's only mine for so long. And, you know, when that mission expires, I've got 3 hours and 40 minutes. So technically, I could have him out there fighting and flying around with me, but that's not a good idea because once I turn on some of the loyalty stuff that goes with the individual mercenaries, by him not being very loyal or by me abusing him in that way, then it's going to ding my faction with his faction, my faction standing. So, but that has not yet been implemented. That's something I need to kind of fiddle around with a little bit. All right, it looks like we made it. Boy, that station is super shiny this close to the sun. All righty, come on. Get. We're so close. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. I know it's been kind of a rambly one, But I just wanted to kind of show you guys that I am making progress, even though it's not that much visual progress. It really is starting to shape up. And the more I play, the more I find little things that need to be fixed and tweaked. And so I just keep doing it until I run out of things to fix. And then we're going to start doing some real testing. All right, so let's go into missions here. I should be turning this guy in. Should give me some good. Ooh, wow. I guess it gave me a lot of experience. I wonder if I'm going to raise the level here. No, I still need another 10,000, but wow, that was still a nice chunk of experience. And I can hold 3 contracts. So, all right, guys. Well, I hope you enjoyed this video. I still got a lot of stuff cooking up, and hopefully within the next week or so, I'll have some pretty major news. Until then, make sure you hit that like button, and if you're new, make sure you subscribe and check back often, and I'll see you guys shortly. Alrighty, Momoguru signing out.